Let us today discuss about Ethernet protocol. Before that, we know that TCP/IP protocol that consisting of 5 layers, and the bottommost layers are physical layer and data link layer. TCP/IP doesn't define any protocols in these 2 layers. Reason is, any protocol that will be used in physical layer and data link layer that will be supported by TCP/IP protocol. We know that LAN is a local area network that is designed for the limited geographic area, and most LANs today also connected to wide area network. Ethernet that has been evolved till date from the standard Ethernet. The standards are defined in IEEE Project 802. In 1985, the Computer Society of the IEEE started a project called Project 802 that defines set of standards for Ethernet. Data link layer that is subdivided into 2 layers. One layer is logical link control and another is media access control. To control the link, the LLC that will come into picture, and to share the channel, MAC that will come into picture. This is the comparison between the TCP/IP suite and IEEE Project 802. Here, in physical layer, we may use Ethernet or maybe token ring or maybe token bus. Respectively, same in the data link layer, in MAC layer, Ethernet, token ring and token bus. Function of logical link control or flow control, error control, and part of the framing duties. Framing that will be handled by both LLC and MAC. As it is link control, it can provide interconnectivity between different LANs. Responsibility of the media access control is it will define the specific access method for each LAN. CSMACD is the method that is used as the media access method for Ethernet LANs. For token bus LANs, we may use token passing method. MAC also that will have the responsibility in framing function. Ethernet that has been evolved in 4 stages. Initially, it is developed by Robert Metcalfe and David Box in 1970s. The first standard is the standard Ethernet. Second is a fast Ethernet, and then gigabit Ethernet and 10 gigabit Ethernet. We can observe here that speed of data transmission in standard Ethernet is 10 Mbps. In fast Ethernet, it is 100 Mbps. In gigabit Ethernet, it is 1 Gbps. And in 10 gigabit Ethernet, it is 10 Gbps. We will discuss about standard Ethernet first. We know the data rate of 10 Mbps that can be achieved in standard Ethernet. And the characteristics are, it is connectionless and unreliable. That means that the Ethernet that is having no connection establishment or connection termination phases. After the frames that are generated, individually frames that will be transmitted. And also it doesn't guarantee that that particular frame that will definitely reach the destination. It is unreliable also. If in case the frame is corrupted and that is being observed by the receiver, it simply discards that particular frame. What is the frame format we are going to use in standard Ethernet? Here we can see that we have preamble, we have SFD, destination address, source address, type, data and padding, CRC. The preamble, here it is 7 bytes in length, it consisting of alternate ones and zeros. This preamble that is used to alert the receiver that the frame that is coming. Once the preamble that reaches the receiver that is going to sync its clock. That means the preamble that allows the receiver to sync the clock. Second field is SFD, that is start frame delimiter. It is 1 byte in length. Last 2 bits are 1, 1. It is the last chance for the receiver to sync. It also indicates that after this SFD, actual frame that is going to arrive. Ethernet frame is variable length frame. So we are going to use the flags to indicate the starting and ending of the frame. Next field is destination address. It is 6 bytes in length, that is 48 bits. This is the link layer address of the receiver. Next field is source address. It is the link layer address of the source. It is also the same length, 6 bytes. Next field is type. This field defines the upper layer protocol, whose packets is encapsulated in the frame. Next field is data and padding. The minimum payload length is 46 bytes. Maximum payload length is 1500 bytes. If the payload length that is less than 46 bytes, so we are going to use the padding. If the payload length is more than 1500 bytes, then we are going to fragment the frame. Consider an example, we have 3000 bytes payload length is there. So then we are going to create two frames, each consisting of 1500 bytes. And each frame that will have separate, so whatever may be the destination address and source address, type and CRC. Next field is CRC, that is used to detect the error. So this is used for error detection. This consisting of 4 bytes length. That will be calculated by using the information of the addresses, type and data. Minimum frame length, that is 512 bits or 64 bytes. Maximum frame length will be 12,144 bits or 1,518 bytes length. Preamble and SMD, so those are physical layer headers. After SFD, the flag will come. After CRC, the flag will be there. So that is one single frame. The question may arise that why the maximum limit that has been defined. The reason is, so if we are not defined the maximum length, single station may occupy the channel for the longer duration and also used for, to reduce the size of the buffer. Addressing each station on an internet network has its own network interface card, that is NIC. Ethernet address is 6 bytes, that is 48 bits. It is normally written in hexadecimal notation with colons. Transmission of address bits. The transmission is left to right. First we are going to transmit 47 and then 20, 1B, 2E, 08, EE. But in this 47, the least significant bit that will be transmitted first. So consider this hexadecimal that is converted into binary, 47 21 B 2 E 08 EE. While transmitting, so this first we are going to transmit LSB, so that is 1. Next 1 1 0 0 0 1 0. Byte by byte, this is how we are going to transmit. Use of this is, we are going to distinguish that whether the frame that is received is for as unicast or multicast or broadcast. So we can find out which address is that. As we know that the Ethernet address is 6 bytes. After in the last bit of the byte 1, so if it is last bit is a 0, then it will define that address is unicast. So if it is 1, that is multicast. So if all the bits in all bytes are 1, that is broadcast. So in this example 47, in first byte and last bit is 1, that means that it is a multicast address. Remember that source address is always a unicast address, because only one source is transmitting either to one device or to many devices or to all the devices. Here in this picture we can see that two topologies. One is the bus topology, a LAN with a bus topology using coaxial cable connection. And another is a LAN with a star topology using a hub. Now consider that in the first case, station A wants to transmit its frame to station G. Then that particular frame that will reach B, C, D, E, F, G, H, all the stations that are connected in a network. But all stations will discard except the intended destination. The collision, if it is going to occur, that will occur in the bus cable. In star topology, in the hub, the collision may occur if more than one stations that are transmitted its frames at the same time. Access method in standard Ethernet. It uses CSMA/CD technique with one persistent method. So that means that it is going to keep on measuring the channel until it finds the channel is idle. If the channel is idle, then it is going to transmit its frame through the channel. It will measure normally less than 100 microseconds. If there is no signal energy on the medium, it means that no station is sending. So station thinks that the medium is idle and it stores its frame. It sends its frame. But that particular station that will keep a copy of the frame in its buffer, because if there is collision occur, so then the same frame that will be retransmitted again. Station needs to send and receive continuously. Why? Because it needs to know that whether the collision that has been occurred or not. So if there is a collision, there will be retransmission. If there is no collision, the frame that is stored in the buffer that will be deleted. We know that minimum frame length is 512 bits. Where does the number 512 bits come from? So consider that transmission rate of Ethernet, so that is 10 Mbps. So to transmit 512 bits, it requires 51.2 microseconds to send out 512 bits. Consider the speed of propagation in the cable is 2×10⁸ meters. Then the first bit that will reach 10,240 meters in one-way communication, half of that in a round-trip communication. Designers of the standard Ethernet actually put a restriction of 2,500 meters, because we must also consider the delays. So if there is a collision that is going to happen, so that will be obviously known by the sending station because the length of the network itself is 2500 meters. So if it is for the round trip, so the bit that is going to travel 5120 meters. So it should refrain from sending if there is a collision that is going to occur. Once the collision that is occurred, the station that is going to send the jump signal that is having 48 bit in length. So it will alert all the stations that are connected in the network that the collision that has been occurred. That is the reason we are going to use 512 bits minimum length of the frame. Efficiency of standard Ethernet. It is defined as the ratio of the time used by a station to send data to the time the medium is occupied by the station. This equation, this is for practical efficiency. And this A is the number of frames that can fit on the medium. And that is the ratio of propagation delay to transmission delay. Note that as the value of parameter A decreases, the efficiency increases. If A is 0, consider like that, so efficiency will become 1. Standard Ethernet that will be implemented in 4 types: 10 base 5, 10 base 2, 10 base T, 10 base F. Standard Ethernet uses a baseband signal, which means that bits are changed to a digital signal and directly sent on the line. We are going to employ the encoding and decoding. At the sender, data are converted to digital signal using Manchester encoder. At the receiver, the received signal that will be decoded by Manchester decoder. 10 base 5 or thick Ethernet, it is also called as thick net, and it uses the topology bus topology, and it uses the external transceivers that are connected via a tap to a thick coaxial cable. Transceiver is responsible for transmitting, receiving and detecting collisions. Here we have two separate paths, one for sending and another for receiving. Maximum length of the coaxial cable should not exceed 500 meters. So if you need more than 500 meters, up to 5 segments, we can use the repeaters. 10 base 2 or thin Ethernet, it is also called as cheaper net. This cable that can be bent easily, so it is thin compared to the thick Ethernet. Here also we are going to use the bus topology. Transceiver is normally part of the network interface card. In the station itself, the transceiver is present. It is not external, it is internal. And length of each segment cannot exceed 185 meters because there will be high level of attenuation in thin coaxial cable as the cable that is going to bend. 10 base T, a twisted pair Ethernet. It uses physical star topology. We have a hub. To that hub, stations are connected. And we are going to use two pairs of twisted cable, one for transmitting and another for reception. The collision that are going to occur, if it occur, then it will occur in the hub only. And the maximum length of the twisted cable here is 100 meter. 10 base F or fiber Ethernet, here the star topology, same, the hub is present. To that hub, the stations are connected, but connection is through the fiber optic cables. and we are going to use the two separate fiber optic cables, transmission and reception purpose.